Let's take a look at the interface pane. So let's close this up. We can shrink our chromatogram back down. We've already seen one portion of the interface pane during our discussion of how to enter compound lists. The second portion of the interface pane is the Conditions tab. This is where all the optimization is performed, so it's really the heart of the Pro EZGC Chromatogram Modeler. We've already discussed the layout of the Conditions tab in Video 1, so I'll just point out that the parameters here are exactly the same as the parameters you'll be setting in your GC software, minus any inlet or detector parameters. We've already seen how we can use the Refine button to shorten our run, but we haven't really discussed the Refine button in depth. In a nutshell, when we click the Refine button, the software will survey all the options for ramp rates and intermediate temperatures in a certain window above and below those values to try to come up with a better model than what we started with. Better is defined by the software as a shorter runtime while still meeting the target resolution parameter that we've set for our model. Please note that this target resolution parameter does not apply to compounds that don't already hit this resolution parameter off the bat. So let's see what happens when we try to refine this model. We can see that the overall runtime has been reduced by about 0.7 minutes. The software decreased the isothermal hold at the beginning of the run, reduced our intermediate temperature in the middle of the run, and reduced our ramp rate at the end of the run. If we want to go back to our original model, we can simply click Undo or use Control Z. The shortcut for redo is Control Y. So let me hit the Refine button again. This time, I want you to keep an eye on the area above the title of our model as I hit the Refine button. We can see the message that 1,521 temperature programs were surveyed to generate this iteration of the model. That's pretty impressive considering it took less than a second. When working with larger lists and more temperature ramps, the survey number can reach over 10 million temperature programs, and it still only takes a few seconds to process. I wanted to point this out because this software does in an instant what no human being would ever be able to do in terms of fine optimization. We can see that the Refine button is still blue, which means that there may still be a better optimized temperature program to be found. Since our separation is still looking pretty good, except for our co-eluting compounds, let's go ahead and refine again. Now the Refine button has been grayed out, and no additional optimizations were possible with the software. Some people have asked me, why would one have to use the Refine button multiple times? Why not just have the software automatically jump to the shortest run while still meeting the target resolution? The answer to that is twofold. First, we didn't want to only display the very fastest run possible because with larger lists, some of the peaks can get really smooshed together, and it's possible that a user would be happier with a slightly lower run that gave better resolution. Allowing multiple refines gives the user a stepwise approach to the minimum resolution criteria that allows them to take a look at the intervening chromatograms in order to stop when they're happy. The second reason is simply that surveying all possible permutations of an oven program in one go takes a lot of computing power. It can be done, and in fact, that's pretty much what ResTech's previous version of the chromatogram modeler did, but the processing time can be a little on the long side. Now that we know what the Refine button does, and we've exhausted its usefulness for this iteration of the model, let's take a look at some of the other parameters. Let's start from the bottom. At the bottom of the parameters window, we have three radio buttons that allow us to set our carrier flow to optimize for efficiency or speed, or to open up all the parameters and enter a custom program. the modeler defaults to speed optimized flow, and we can see that our flow is set to 2.56 mils per minute. If we click the efficiency button, we can see that our flow is reduced down to 1.79 mils per minute. This flow rate is at the absolute optimal flow rate for this column dimension with helium carrier gas. So why is it that the resolution between toluene and 2-hexanone decreased when we switched over to a more efficient flow rate? The reason is that although the flow rate has changed and the model did update, no changes were made to the oven program by the software. By changing our flow but not updating our oven program, we changed the elution temperatures of our compounds of interest. In order to get the same optimized separation for the new flow rate, we would need to translate the oven program for our new flow rate. We can do this with ResTech's method translator, but before we do that, let's try something a little easier. Because we changed our flow and elution temperatures, the refine button is highlighted again, indicating that more optimization is possible. Let's see what happens. If we take a look at our resolution here, we can see that it got a little better. So let's try to refine until we cannot refine anymore and see how good we can get our resolution. There's one, two, three. So we can see that we've regained the resolution between toluene and 2-hexanone by using the refine button. Generally, when we change between speed and efficiency mode, we can use refine to fix any changes in resolution that occur due to the lack of oven program translation. And one thing to note is that if we were to simply translate the original oven program, we would end up with an equivalent chromatogram as what we started with before switching to efficiency optimized flow, but the total program time would be 15 minutes instead of only about 12. This means that the software was not only able to fix the loss of resolution, but it also came up with a faster result than we would have gotten from using translation alone. Moving up from the radio buttons, we can see that above our program, we have our outlet pressure. Let's pretend that we're using mass spec so we can all feel better about these coelutions that we're seeing right here. If we're using MS, we need to make sure we have our outlet pressure set to vacuum. So look at the model. When we did this, we ended up changing the linear velocity, thus changing our elution temperatures yet again. We can see that we have a slightly shorter runtime, and we've actually improved the resolution between toluene and 2-hexanone. Also, because we made changes, our refine button is available again. So let's see what we get. We're down to just under a 9-minute run now, but I kind of liked having the improved resolution between peaks 12 and 13, so I'm going to go back to where we were by hitting undo. Oop, went a little too far. Redo. Okay. Because we're not in custom mode, our flow parameters are locked by the software. We can definitely change these if we want, but in my experience, the software does a pretty good job by itself most of the time. Just remember, whenever you change column flows or linear velocities, elution temperatures are changed, which may either improve or degrade your separation. Use the refine button to see if you have any better options anytime you change elution temperatures.